This industrial site needs a lot of power, but Scottish Woodlands wanted to be in control of their own energy. With 108 solar panels, 3 Victron Energy 15 kVA quattro inverter chargers, and 91 kilowatt hours of lithium batteries, the aim this week is to provide a stable 3-phase supply. This brand new workshop is set within 100 acres of Scottish woodland, and getting mains grid electricity here wouldn't be an easy task.
One of the mains routes would probably likely mean overhead cables. The overhead cables would have impacted our forestry operations. They would have given us another hazard. They would have meant that we couldn't plant all the ground that we possibly wanted to replant. So getting the off-grid supply within here, that took all these problems away. So there was no interface with any other landowners, and we held it all within ourselves. We were in control.
Scottish Woodlands provide forestry management services, new planting of trees, as well as harvesting them. On this site, it's a mix of productive commercial conifers, mature woodlands, open space, and a small lock. This building has been built for the utility division. They conduct large tree cutting projects for Network Rail and Scottish Power, as well as clearing land for wind farms and maintaining services run smoothly.
We looked at the overall power demand on site, and also talking to Scottish Woodlands, we realised that the site would be developed over time and their power needs would increase. Initially, there's this warehouse area which needed power and lighting. Even the roller shutter itself needed a small 3-phase supply.
The site as a whole, we use it as a training facility for our operatives that are existing and joining the company to learn to actually use the machines in the field. I was delighted when I spoke to Ian, not only I could get rapid energy storage all year round, extremely minimal generator support, and 3-phase. And Ian's taken that forward with the design. He's brought all the team together, and you know, literally 4 or 5 months from contacting him, we're going to be up and running.
We chose the largest quattros, largely because they've already or soon will have some quite high demands. But certainly moving into the future, it's very difficult to tell how much power they may need 3, 4, 5, 10 years in advance. So they were happy to install and a system which would future-proof them, so we could fit it and then they can carry on and develop the site without any concerns over their power requirements.
On the roof, Off-Grid Engineering are installing 43 kilowatts of monocrystalline panels. Each 400 watt panel is mounted in portrait in 3 rows, totaling 108 panels. The cabling for these is brought down the side of the building and into the area where the electrics are being installed. The solar is brought through a disconnect switch and into a Victron Energy MPPT RS 450 volt 100 amp smart solar charge controller. They are then fused in a Lynx distributor, ready to go to the battery bank. The batteries will be delivered in a second install stage, and there will be 91 kilowatts of BYD lithium iron phosphate batteries. Lastly, to invert the DC power, there are 3 48 volt 15 kVA quattro inverter chargers. These will also be used to link the generator to the system.
We have a backup generator as well, which I would imagine they're unlikely to use for quite some time. The solar array itself is capable of charging the entire battery bank from empty in 2 to 3 hours, so that pretty much takes care of them seasonally. However, if they do need backup, we have a 60 kVA Hyundai 3-phase generator, which will be hooked up to the system as well through the servo, and will be on an auto start, so if the batteries ever do get close to a low state of charge. It will auto start just to run for say an hour to bridge the gap in between the solar input. But also if they manage to max out the supply across any of the one or all three phases, the high under generator can kick in as well. So in total then we will have 45 kVA available direct from the Victron inverters, plus another 65 kVA available from the generator as well. So 110 kVA three phase in total.
Scott has set up the Servo GX to turn the generator on and off remotely and is giving it an initial test.
We were very surprised when we first spoke to Ian, particularly that we could get three phase. Some of the plant to do the maintenance is best served with a three phase system. It was something that we would have preferred but weren't sure we could have. So we were delighted to hear that Ian could supply that, and the site would lend itself to largely, you know, low use of any other support to back up the system, so delighted.
Now the batteries have arrived and set up, it's time to stress test the system to ensure it's all working correctly. In comes a big, power-hungry, three-phase wood-cutting machine, but will it work? There is a welfare building not far from the main site, and until now it's required a small generator to run all day, every day, just to provide a small amount of electricity for toilets, a small kitchen and an office. Today the generator is being turned off as Scott has installed the connection to the main shed.
Scottish Woodlands is a forest management company. We work in a sustainable industry. We plant trees, we have new planting, we fell trees, we harvest them, they go off the sawmills, they go in the UK housing and board and panel industry. From that, we replant these existing woods. It's a very green industry to be in, and something we're all quite proud of being in. This site here is in a rural area, however we wanted to have the minimal impact within the area, and the easiest way of doing that was to try and do everything we can within the site. So by having the solar system, it just brings all that together.
With the system now fully installed and commissioned, Scottish Woodlands are already discussing replicating this setup across other sites.
With all that's going on in the world just now, electricity costs, supplies, resources in general are what everybody's talking about. We're delighted to be in a position here where we're in control. We have our own electricity, we're generating our own electricity, where we can budget for what it's going to cost, budget what it's going to cost to maintain. So, you know, we feel we've future-proofed the business against outside influence. So that's very important to us. As far as cost, when we got the cost from Ian through for the project, it wasn't going to be significantly more than a grid connection. And so in real terms, we're producing free electricity beyond that. So we expect the system to easily pay itself for itself in 3 to 4 years. A grid connection we'd have been still spending. So as a business, we're delighted.
With energy prices continuing to increase, it simply shortens the payback timescale. Scottish Woodlands now has renewable energy to not only keep their facilities running, but as the site increases in size, into the future too. Take a look at how other businesses have benefited from being off-grid on the Markets Industrial page on the Victron Energy website.